Hey, what's up everyone? Ray Sawville, raysawville.com. In today's video, we are going to be going through bid strategies in detail, knocking out every single one within Google Ads. So if that's what you're looking for, make sure to stick around. Bidding is extremely crucial for every single one of your campaigns, and it's essentially what you're telling Google the amount you are willing to pay every single time that your ad goes up for auction. So depending on how long you've been in the space, this has evolved over time, and more recently they've been moving more towards automated bidding strategies, which are kind of like the best of the best nowadays. But I'm going to be going through the different bidding strategies that are available and how to get there. So if you select tools and settings on the top of your screen and then go to bid strategies, you'll get almost all of the bidding strategies, but we're going to start off here first. And then if you click on this blue button or portfolio bid strategy, you'll get an idea of which ones are available to you right now, which is good enough for this tutorial. So we're going to start off at the top. And before going through each one of these in depth, you're going to notice things like target metrics along with maximize metrics and then impression share metrics. So when I think about bidding strategies, you need to think about where your campaign falls in the funnel, because if you do not think about it that way, your bidding strategy is going to change entirely. So if you pull up like any kind of marketing funnel, I just typed in marketing funnel into Google Ads and got a extremely basic one here. But if you think about like awareness, consideration, and conversion, your conversion based campaigns, where the main goal of those campaigns is literally just to try to get like transactions or phone calls or form fills, and it's not like awareness based potentially, you're gonna wanna focus on things like target CPA, target ROAS, return on ad spend, or maximize conversions or maximize conversion values. These are like fully automated bidding strategies where Google will take in millions of signals when going out to auction and using all the data at its disposal to kind of determine what is the best bid for that user at that point in time based on their search query. There's so many things that go into it, and it's extremely crucial that when you go out and you go out and bid, you think about the funnel, because if you don't and you have the wrong goal set up and you don't have that in mind, your campaigns aren't going to be set up in a way where they're ultimately not going to succeed in the long term. Now, you might get some short-term results, but long term they're not going to be sustainable and likely won't work as well as they could if you consider the funnel when you first started. So typically when I'm working in my accounts or with my team, I typically like to talk about how do we get to a target CPA or target ROAS as best as possible, if that's the type of campaign we're moving towards. And I'll go through the settings here in a minute. The other ones you want to think about, and not that these won't work for conversions, but if you're just looking for like a ton of traffic to your website and you just want to drive as many clicks to your site as possible, maximize clicks is the way to go. You can just set, here is the maximum amount I'm willing to pay for every single click, no matter how qualified they are. If they're searching for my products, I just want to get them to my site, this is the one for you. It's not going to consider those conversion ready metrics. However, it will just try to get people to your site based on what you're willing to pay. If you're looking way, way top of funnel, you're going to want to consider target impression share. That is where you're looking to see how many impressions, what impression share do you want to sit at when bidding? And then when looking at like YouTube campaigns or display, you can go like CPM based, things like that. But this is primarily for search and shopping. So keep that in mind when you're going out there. Now, the last piece that you're going to see when setting up campaigns is definitely manual bidding. Now, manual bidding is definitely not as supported as it used to be in the past. There's something called enhanced cost per click bidding. So the way I got here is if you go to settings on one of your campaigns, go to bidding, and then select the bid strategy directly, you're able to then select what bid strategy you would like. You'll see that there's manual CPC, which is fine if you really want to get granular on what you're targeting. However, humans just aren't able to, like, we can't stack up against Google's algorithm. Like there's no way over time, especially if you have all these millions of signals. Target CPA and target ROAS, it's the way of the future. Go that route. Highly recommend it. Test it. Try it. If you haven't tried it recently, try it again. It works, I promise. Test it out. But manual CPC is another route you can go where you can go out and individually set those bids at the keyword level, which used to be pretty common practice 3 to 4 years ago prior to these smart bidding strategies. So The rest of this video is going to be highly focused on setting up those smart bidding campaigns, and I'll have a further video down the line on how to optimize those smart bidding campaigns. So if that's something you're looking for, make sure to comment down below. And also make sure to subscribe. Thank you. So now that you know where your campaign falls within the marketing funnel, we're going to go through each one of these options at a high level and how you can at least hit the ground running and start going. Now, this also assumes that you have conversion tracking set up, because in order for target CPA and target ROAS and maximize conversions, any of these smart bidding strategies to work well, your conversion actions need to be solid. So I'll have a further video down the line that'll be linked somewhere on the screen where you can ensure that your conversion actions are set up correctly, because if you're optimizing for a certain CPA or a certain return on ad spend and your conversion actions aren't set up correctly, the algorithm is going to be optimizing towards an incorrectly configured conversion action, which is going to cause your campaigns to implode and not work properly. And if you do not have that fundamental piece set up, things are not going to work for you, and you're going to complain like I did when I first started doing smart bidding campaigns and say, why isn't this working for me? What is the issue? And I promise you, these campaigns work nowadays, and they work well. So for target CPA, again, this is how much are you willing to pay for every single lead that comes in, whether it's a transaction, phone call, any type of conversion action. So you're going out and you're telling Google, I want to spend this much per conversion action. And you can even go out and say, let's only optimize around this specific action, which you can do that at the campaign level. You know, you can go out here from a bidding perspective and say, for this specific campaign, I want to pay $50 or whatever your CPA is, or whatever is profitable for you from a lead perspective. I can't tell you what that number is, unfortunately. But you can go out, apply that to that specific campaign and say, I'm willing to pay $50 for every single lead. I don't want to go higher than $100. I mean, you can choose what that is if you want to have a specific bid limit. Like, I don't want to go higher than $25 per bid or something along those lines. You can set those caps. In my experience, I like to let the system go out there and just optimize and learn, because over time, I don't really care what I'm bidding. If I'm spending $40 per click and I'm getting conversions, I don't really care. Like, if it's hitting my goal, go spend as much as you want. I don't care, for the most part. So keep that in mind as you're optimizing. So that's target CPA. The next one is target ROAS, or target return on ad spend. So let's say you're an e-commerce business and you want to go make 3-to-1 on your spend. You would go to this bidding strategy and set a 300% return on ad spend, meaning the algorithm would go out and set a 3-to-1 return on ad spend and try to optimize around that. Now, one thing to keep in mind, if you're hitting a constant 2x and you go out and tell Google, get me a 10x return, you're going to get extremely low search volume and your campaigns are going to hardly serve. So being realistic with your target metric here and along with your keyword targeting is extremely important, because if you set this metric too high or too low, it's just going to cause the system to go haywire. So I'm not saying don't change this metric, but ensure that it is accurate enough for you to be profitable as a business. So again, target ROAS, my example was 3-to-1, so you would type in 300%. I have seen people do I want to go get a 300 or a 3x return on ad spend. I've seen people type in 3 here. Major yikes. You don't want to do that, because if you go that route, you're telling Google to go get you 3 pennies back on your dollar. Not good. You probably don't want to go that route. So this is whatever your return on ad spend is, ensure you're typing in that right percentage. Pretty straightforward. Same thing with clicks again, guys. You just tell Google exactly how much are you willing to pay per click if you want to go that route. So again, if you just want to get a ton of traffic to your website, you can set into some kind of threshold for your bidding. Maximize conversions is honestly straight out the box. There's really not much you do here. You just assign that to your campaign and Google will try to max out your budget and get you as many conversions as possible. Same thing with conversion value. This one, it's going to try to get you the most amount of conversions as possible, but it's also going to try to get you the highest conversion value as possible. So if you sell products that are $500 and one that's $50, it's going to try its best to get you those higher average order values. In my experience, it does okay. Again, these are kind of the creme de la creme of bidding strategies, the target CPA and target ROAS. So aim for those as much as you can. And again, the final one here is target impression share. So if you just have a pure brand play where it's awareness or consideration, and you're just for this set of keywords or my brand, I want to have 90% impression share or 95% impression share. You can go out there and say, hey, I want to be on the top of the page. I want to be in the 90 percentile. And I want to pay $4 or whatever. This is purely impression based. Now, my thoughts on impression share have changed pretty drastically over the past couple of years. Back in the day, I wanted to make sure I was just dominating that space. I wanted to bid all the time. But with these smart bidding strategies, I'd rather show up 40% of the time on these tCPA or tROAS campaigns for the most conversion-ready action campaigns, if that's what my objective is, compared to just showing up every single time and potentially wasting money. So that's one last consideration. The last piece I'm going to leave you with here, as we kind of roll down on smart bidding, is we talked about conversion actions. And again, a link will be somewhere on the screen about making sure that those are set up properly. The other thing I want to talk about is the conversion setting for your campaign. So if you select your campaign, go to settings and then click on conversions here. You may have to click on more. You need to ensure that Google is optimizing for the proper conversion action that you want it to. So let's say you have 10 conversion actions in the account. You've got one for your transactions, a lead form, a phone call, all sorts of different things. If you don't have the setup the right way, Google's gonna just assign the same value to everything. You need to make sure that's all buttoned up. So that's another video down the line. Comment down below, depending on how quickly you want that. I can turn that around pretty quickly, but let me know if that's something that's valuable. But yeah, that's about it. Smart bidding is honestly here to stay. Bidding strategies are so crucial, so important for making sure your campaigns perform efficiently and productively. So comment down below. Let me know if you have any questions. Make sure to subscribe if you guys like this kind of content and you would like to see more digital marketing campaigns and videos down the line. Love making this kind of stuff. So if you have any questions, let me know. Appreciate it. Thanks so much. See ya.